safe to do so. Yards. Turn left. Turn left.
Mission accomplished. I have another one in mind that you would absolutely nail if you're up for it.
Hey, amiga. I've still got bonus boards up here, cuz.
Why not?
We'll smash them all. I'm serious. I can't remember where we hit them.
Calculating route. In 400 yards, turn sharp left. Sharp right. Turn sharp right. Yards. Turn sharp left. Arrived at your destination.
Thank you.
have arrived at your destination. Turn around when it is safe to do so. Turn around when it is safe to do so. Yards, turn right. Turn right. Yards. Turn left. Turn left.
We're going to make a documentary about Hot Wheels history. Come on, I'll need your help. Yards, turn right. Turn right.
There's something really special about taking a bunch of professional drivers, grouping them up into teams, and having them race all across Mexico. If you ever just want to race, Horizon Tour is your answer.
At your destination.
So, where's our special guest? The Hot Wheels expert.
Haven't figured it out yet, have you? Get in!
At the time, there was nothing out there like that. rail recaps that allow the cars to roll super fast, while Harry made them look super eye-catching. Harry and Jack's contributions became the pillars of Hot Wheels, performance and design. The first car off the production line was a custom Camaro, a lot like the one you're driving right now.
See what you did there?
Yeah! And another of the original 16 was the custom Fleetside, based on Harry's custom Chevy El Camino. Most of those early designs were inspired by hot rods and muscle cars, which were popular in California car culture at the time. After Harry Bradley, more designers joined the team, like Ira Guilford from Chrysler, who did the twin mill, and Larry Wood from Ford, who designed the original Bone Shaker. But right from the beginning, they were designing cars to do one thing above all: roll really, really fast on plastic tracks.
You've done your research.
Research? I memorized this stuff when I was 6 years old. One reason why Hot Wheels are so eye-catching is because of a special case called Spectraflame. They use a transparent lacquer applied over a polished zinc plating, which gave it a totally awesome metallic effect, just like a real car. Since then, Hot Wheels has broadened and developed its paint techniques to support a variety of looks and effects. Fascinating stuff, right? Another detail was the red stripe on the tyres, like the one you're driving now. They called them red line tyres, and they look so cool! Redline tyres are a defining characteristic of this era and are really sought after by collectors. Nice drive. Here, take the Nash Custom 1957. Winner of the Legends Tour 2019.
Thanks, Hayley. Hey, let's do this again soon.
Welcome back, Vincent.
Goddamn thing. Why are you playing with me today?
Listen to this. I met some American collectors at the festival last night, and they said they were close to tracking down a stone-cold classic right here in Mexico. So, I was thinking, if we find it first...
Thank you.
They turned it down from up to. Look at my ass without. Thank you.
Turn left. In 100 yards, turn left. Calculating route. In 200 yards, turn left. turn around when it is safe to do so.